हेलो, दिस इज नंबर्स लेसन 9। इन दिस आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द सक्सेसिव डिवीजन। आई विल स्टार्ट विद अ क्वेश्चन। विद अ क्वेश्चन आई विल एक्सप्लेन द कॉन्सेप्ट। फाइंड द रिमाइंडर्स व्हेन 89 इज सक्सेसिवली डिवाइडेड बाय 7 एंड 5। व्हाट इट मींस, फर्स्ट वी विल डिवाइड 89 बाय 7। नाउ 7 12 जा वी नो दैट 84, द रिमाइंडर इज 5। 7 12s are 84, the remainder is 5. Now, when I say successive division, this 12, your first quotient, will become the number for the second division. The first quotient 12 will become the number for the second division. Now, 12 divisor, second divisor is 5. 5 2s are 10, the remainder is 2. So, my answer are 5 and 2. My answer is 5 and 2, I'm just writing here, 5 and 2. My remainders are 5 and 2. When 89 is successively divided by 7 and 5. The important concept and the only concept in successive division is that your first quotient, this 12, your first quotient, I'm just making some color out of here. First quotient will become the number for the second division. That is the basic of successive division. Second question is, find the remainders when 47 is successively divided by 5, 4 and 3. First, I will divide 47 by 5. This is the first divisor. 5 9s are 45. The remainder is 2. Now, very important, this your first quotient 9 will become the number or dividend for the second division. 9. Next divisor is 4. 4 2s are 8. The remainder is 1. The second quotient 2 will become the number or dividend for the third division. This 2, third divisor is 3. Now 2 is not divisible by 3. So quotient is 0, 3, 0, 0, the remainder is 2. Important thing again in this is that the quotient of the first division will become the number for the second, and the quotient for the second division becomes the number for the third division. That is what you need to understand. This 9 was the quotient, it becomes a number for the second division. The 2 quotient of second division will become the numbers for the third division. And that is the basics of successive division. So my answer is 2, 1 and 2. These are the remainders when a number is successively divided by 5, 4 and 3. This is question 3. A natural number n, when successively divided by 7, 5 and 3, gives remainder as 5, 3 and 2 respectively. Here we need to find the number. In the first two question, number was given to us. These are a bit difficult question as compared to the first two. We need to first find the minimum value of n, and there are two more questions. Now let's start. We don't know the number. Let's say number is n. When divided by first divisor is 7, the remainder is, first remainder is 5. We don't know the quotient. Let's say quotient is A. This A, the first quotient will become the number for the second division. Second divisor is 5. Second remainder is 3. We don't know the second quotient. Let's say it is equals to B. This B will become the number for the third division. Third divisor is 3. And third remainder is 2. Again, we don't know the quotient. Let's say quotient is C. Now in this way, we will not be able to solve, or it will take whole lot of calculation to solve the question like this. Now what to do? Now in such kind of questions, it's better to proceed from the reverse method. Reverse method is that we will first solve the third division. Let's say third divisor was 3, third remainder was 2. Let's say the third quotient was k. So what would be a number? Number would be, number we know that is divisor into quotient plus remainder. 3 is the divisor, k is the quotient. Number would be 3k plus 2. This will be a number. Now I know that we are going by reverse method. You can see in this question, this b, second quotient become the number for the third division. Here I will apply the same concept. The number for the third division will become the quotient for the second. So this will become same 3k plus 2. Now my second divisor was 5, the remainder was 3. What will be my second number? My second number would be, number is divisor into quotient plus remainder. 5 3s are 15k plus 5 into 2 10 plus remainder 3 13. I have just applied the division theorem. Number I know that is divisor into quotient plus remainder. This 15k plus 3. Now see the above division. This A, the number for the second division was the quotient for the first division. So I will apply the same concept. The number for the second division will become the quotient for the first division. 15k plus 13. I know the first divisor is 7. First remainder was 5. So what will be my number? Number is divisor into quotient plus remainder. So 7 into 15k plus 13. So my number would be 7 into 15k is 105k plus 7 into 13 is 91 plus 5 96. So can I say my number is 105k plus 96. So in this way you can speedily find the number by going the reverse method. So number is 105k plus 96. Now we can solve so many questions on the base of this number 105k plus 96. The first question was, we need to find the minimum value of n. For minimum value of n, I will put k is equals to 0, because the last quotient, k was the last quotient, here was the k was the last quotient, and last quotient can be 0. Minimum value of k is 0. So minimum, when put k is equals to 0, n would be 96. This is the answer of first question. 96 is my answer. Second is that, second question, how many values of n are possible given that n is less than 1000? That was the second question. How many values of n are possible given that n is less than 1000? Now here you need to check how many values of k we can put. K can be ranged from 0, because when you put k is equal to 0, it becomes k1 is also possible, k2, k3, up to k8. Because 105 into 8 plus 96, it will be less than 1000. We can't put k is equal to 9, because by putting k is equal to 9, if you put k is equal to 9, number will become 105 into k plus 96, that is 105 into 9 plus 96, this will be greater than 1000. So I don't need this. So minimum, maximum value of k would be 8. So how many values are possible? 0 to 8, there are 9 numbers. So 9 values of n number is possible, which are less than 1000. So there are 9 numbers which gives the remainder 5, 3, 2 when successfully divided by 7, 5 and 3. 96 is the minimum, and there are 9 such numbers are possible. Maximum number, third question was that, maximum 3 digit number. Now maximum 3 digit number will definitely come when we put k is equals to 8. When we put k is equals to 8, number will become 105k plus 96, that is 105 into 8 plus 96, 840 plus 96, this become 936. So 930 is the maximum 3 digit number which when divided by successively 7, 5 and 3 will give me remainders as 5, 3 and 2 respectively. So I have answered all the 3 questions. Fourth question is, a number when successfully divided by 9 and 7 gives remainder as 5 and 3. The same number when successfully divided by 7 and 9, the remainders are what? Now we know that how to find the number when successive division is given. Again, I will go by the reverse method. In this case, I will try to solve in a faster manner. The second divisor is 7, the second remainder is 3. Let's say quotient is k, so 7k plus 3 will be the number. Number is divisor into quotient plus remainder. This 7k plus 3 will become the quotient for the first division. 7k plus 3. Now first divisor was 9. First remainder is 5. So number is divisor into quotient. 9 into 7k 63k plus 9 3s are 27 plus 5 32. So my number is 63k plus 32. where k is a natural number. Here is your number, n is equals to 63k plus 32. Now what the question says that this n when successfully divided by 7 and 9. Earlier it was 9 and 7, now it's 7 and 9 as written in the question. Now 7 and 9, what will be the remainder? Now this question you can solve in two ways. Either you can put any values of k, still the answer will be the same. Otherwise you can take the general value of n. Now first I will take the general values of n. 63k plus 32, first I will divide it by 7. Now 7, 9k plus 4 it will go. So 7 9s are 63k plus 28, the first remainder is 4. Now this divisor 9, this divisor, this quotient 9k plus 4 will be the number for the second division. Now second divisor is 9, this is k, 9k, the remainder is 4, because 4 is not divisible by 9, the remainders are 4 and 4 respectively. So when the same number is divided by 7 and 9, the remainder is 4 and 4. Otherwise the second method is, you can simply take k is equals to 0, the minimum value of k, the number would be 32. First successively divided by 7, 7 4s are 28, remainder is 4, this 4 becomes the number, 9, 0, 0, remainder is 4, again answer is 4 and 4. So these kind of question you can find in exam in less than a minute. It won't take much time. The only thing you have to first go by backward. First assume that quotient is k and you find the number 63k plus 32. Then k, put k is equal to 0 or 1, whatever is convenient to you. Easy would be k is equal to 0 and find the remainders in the second case. That was all about the successive division. Thank you.